Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Today we're going to talk about pointing devices. We work with a lot of folks who have issues related to spinal cord injury, cerebral palsy, other things that make it difficult for folks to use their hands to type on a keyboard. So in those situations, we use different kinds of pointing devices to help people. So for example, you might be familiar with a regular mouse, which is shaped sort of like this, but this is a mouse that's turned on its side so that it sits like this and somebody puts their hand here and is able to move the pointer around on their screen. And I've got a number of devices here that do the same kind of thing. They're all like a mouse, but they're shaped differently. This one is a trackball. You put your hand down here and your thumb allows you to move your pointing device around like that. This one is shaped like a pen. So you hang on to this like so, and you move it around, and it still is a mouse, it's just shaped differently. We've got all different kinds of them. This is designed for somebody who might have arthritis, or maybe a spinal cord injury that makes it difficult for them to pinch their hands or move their fingers around. So this one, you lay your hand on here, and you slide this pointing device around. We've got all kinds of things. This one's shaped like a joystick, similar kind of motion. This is a smaller version of a standard mouse, and it also has a small trackball right here. This is one that has a key guard on it, so that people can move their hands around on here, but not hit the buttons accidentally. We've also taken this one and mounted it on an arm, so that somebody with a spinal cord injury can move their chin around like so and control the computer. This ball cap right here has a special reflective surface right here that works with a camera that sits on the computer so that head movement is then controlled, or that head movement allows you to control the mouse and move the pointer around on your screen. So we're going to go on the screen here and I'm going to show you why these pointing devices can turn into a very important way for folks to access a computer. So go onto the screen with me here and we're going to see a little bit more about how pointing devices can be combined with an on-screen keyboard to make some magic happen.
Okay, so once we've figured out which pointing device is going to work for a person and their limited mobility, then we want to combine that with an on-screen keyboard here. So I'm using a laptop with Windows Vista. If you click on the Start button, and then click on All Programs, then click on Accessories, you're going to find the Ease of Access Center. And in a future video, we're going to cover a lot of things about that, but we're going to access the on-screen keyboard. And the on-screen keyboard is exactly what you would expect it to be. It's basically a virtual keyboard that sits here on your desktop that you can use with a pointing device. So what you can see here is I'm moving my mouse around and I can be using any one of those pointing devices that we talked about to point at a letter. Now let me also start up Microsoft Word so we have something to type into here. And now what I have is a situation where I don't need to use the keyboard to type things. I can use my my adaptive pointing device and this on-screen keyboard. So I can say, "Hi, my name is," and you can go on and on and type all kind of things. And you'll see that this keyboard has the function keys, the escape keys, all the different keys that you would need to control your computer, including the Windows key and those kind of things. So if you take this on-screen keyboard, which is free, by the way, any computer later than Windows 98 is going to have something available like this. You're going to find it either in the control panel or the Ease of Access Center. You can combine this with one of these pointing devices and have a way to access the keyboard without actually accessing the keyboard.
So you can see, whether you want to write an email or just play solitaire, pointing devices can help folks with disabilities be really, really more independent. So that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project in Indiana.